French poet Jackie happened to meet a blind beggar in the street. Jackie asked him how things were going. So the beggar said, "Ah, bad." Because he hadn't heard a single coin land in his hat that day. So Jackie himself was a poor writer. So he didn't have much cash to spare. But he offered to rewrite the sign that explained the beggar situation. 2 weeks later, when Jackie met that blind beggar again, things had actually improved. People were more generous now, and his hat was always full. So what did Jackie wrote on the beggar's sign? He had written, "Spring is coming, but I won't see it." I will repeat. He had written, "Spring is coming, but I won't see it." Now, why this statement made people more generous towards that beggar? The answer is, the brain is wired, our human brain is wired to find stories more engaging and memorable than simple statements. And you may ask a follow-up question, but why our brain finds stories more engaging? It is because neuroscientists have found that in our brain, neurons that fire together, wire together. I will repeat, neurons that fire together, wire together. What they mean is that when multiple parts of the brain are working together, then we are much more likely to remember. Logical statements like, "I am blind, please donate," for example, engage just two parts of the brain. Those which is responsible for language processing and comprehension. But when we hear stories like, "Spring is coming, but I won't see it," our brain lights up like a switchboard. Because suddenly we are processing language, we are processing comprehension, we are processing emotions, we are processing images, and we are processing imaging sensations. This bombardment of neurons make the second statement much more sticky. Now let's take another situation. Say Dharmender and Hema Malini. They were next door neighbors and childhood friends. Later they fell in love with each other. There was no romantic rivals, no villain to come between them. And they both were happy to stay in their hometown. Their family is also thought that they both are a perfect match. And hence, finally, they got married and they continued to live happily. Now tell me, is this a cute story? Yes, it is a cute story. But will you spend 3 hours and maybe $1,000 on theater ticket and popcorns to watch this story there? I don't think so. But what is the problem in this story? The problem is, this story is dull. It is boring. And this story is not relatable. Why it is not relatable? Because our real life is not so straight. It is not so easy. So the second takeaway from this book is that the story has to be something people can connect with, relate with. That was the second takeaway. Now let's move to the third part, which says relatability on its own is not enough. Because to keep the audience hooked, to keep the listeners hooked, the hero has to go through roller coaster ride. But why? Why he has to go through roller coaster ride? Because our brain lights up when we see or hear something which is totally new. And this is the reason that you will see and you will find that there are many programs on satellite TV these days in which they are showing ghosts, giants, spirits and whatnot, and they are getting good TRP for this super hypothetical programs and stories. And why it is happening? Because it is serving to that part of the brain which requires novelty. So if I have to conclude three key takeaways from this book, the first one is the human brain is wired to find stories more engaging, more memorable than simple statements. That was one. Second, the story has to be something people can connect with, people can relate with. Third, that great stories have novelty and some amount of tension into it. If you want to hear more from me on this topic, then please comment below or like this video. Thank you so much and have a fantastic life.